A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 28 November, on the front page you have NCP to get Deputy CM post. Speaker will be from Congress. So we have seen regarding government formation in Maharashtra, BJP Chief Minister Devendra Fadnavis was sworn in by the governor, but then after the Supreme Court said that you have to prove your majority, have a floor test done in the Legislative Assembly within 24 hours, he resigned. He had been supported by NCP member Ajit Pawar, and he had they had claimed that they had a quota of NCP MLAs. But now Ajit Pawar, after the cases have been withdrawn against him, the 70,000 crore irrigation scam case, that case has been closed as such. The open inquiry has been closed, and now you can see Ajit Pawar is back with NCP as such, and you can see that government would be formed with an alliance among Congress, Shiv Sena and NCP. Chief Minister post goes to Uddhav Thackeray, that has been announced. So Shiv Sena gets the Chief Minister's post, Deputy CM post goes to NCP, and Speaker will be from Congress. Then this is India's Cartosat 3 plus 13 nano satellites put in orbit. So this is regarding the Cartosat 3 satellite, which we have been discussing for long now. This is a third generation satellite. Mapping satellite. Cartography means mapping. So Cartosat is mapping satellite of India, and along with 13 nano satellites from US. So they have been put in orbit using PSLV C-47. So here you can see it is the 74th launch vehicle mission from Satish Dhawan Space Center. It's the 49th flight of PSLV. PSLV is in XL configuration. It's the 9th satellite of Cartosat series. Then here you have Finance Minister during a discussion in Rajya Sabha, she replied that it is not recession yet. So economic growth has slowed, but economy was not in recession is what she claims, not yet. Then here you have questions raised over UP encounter. So in Uttar Pradesh, an encounter happened. As the police claims, on October 17, Shaiman Khan, 20-year-old, was shot by the UP police in an alleged encounter at Kankar Khera area. So, FIR has been registered, and in this FIR, it has been stated that Mr. Khan had dropped a sports bike and a mobile phone from a man on October 10, and the incident happened on October 17. Police said he suffered one gunshot injury when they fired in self-defense, but medical reports show that he suffered 3 bullet injuries. And Mr. Khan himself says that the encounter was staged and the charges against him are false because he has the bill to prove that he bought the bike. Police have dismissed this as clerical error, that the dates which have come and the details which have been given are clerical error while registering the FIR. So this is how encounters take place in UP, you can see. And this is SPG bill passed amid opposition walkout in Lok Sabha. So here you can see the Special Protection Group Amendment Bill, which has been proposed. It has been passed in Lok Sabha now. So we had seen it means that only Prime Minister would get SPG cover, security cover. It's a Special Protection Group cover. It would not be for former Prime Ministers. Also, it would not be for family members of Prime Ministers who do not stay with them. And even if they stay with them, it would be only for a period of 5 years. This is the bill passed in Lok Sabha now. So former Prime Ministers and the immediate family members to get cover for 5 years under this. On page 6 you have, now Meghalaya outfit wants separate flag. So after the IM faction of NSCN, that is of Nagaland, an extremist group from Nagaland, has demanded a separate flag, now an extremist group from Meghalaya is also demanding a separate flag and a constitution as part of its peace deal with Centre. So, Citizenship Amendment Bill is what the central government wants to pass, and this has resulted in tribal states waking up and demanding greater powers for them, and also they want a separate flag for themselves. On page 7 you have Gujarat to enforce new anti-terror law from December 1. So, Gujarat's controversial anti-terror law that has several draconian provisions like interception of telephonic talks as legitimate evidence and intercepted telephonic talks, and also statements before police officials of SP rank being admissible as evidence in the court. So, this draconian bill is going to be enforced from December 1. President Ramnath Kovind has given his assent to this bill. This is called Gujarat Control of Terrorism and Organized Crime Act. It has thrice failed to get the nod from three previous presidents since 2004 because of the draconian provisions and apparent sweeping powers given to the police. But now this revised version of the controversial bill has been passed by BJP government in the state in 2015 and has been given by the assent by the president too. So the government claims this is to deal with terrorism and organized crimes such as contract killing, Ponzi schemes, narcotics trade, extortion rackets, cyber crime, land grabbing and human trafficking. On page 8 you have this: police seek more information on IS linked Kerala woman. So we have seen regarding this news earlier too. Kerala police now wants more information on Keralites, you know, who have been suspected to be among the Islamic State fighters who are in the custody of Afghan law enforcement authorities in Khorasan province as such. So more details of these ladies have been sought. And this is ISRO's launch tally hits 5 main satellites this year. So Indian Space Research Organization has touched a tally of launching 5 main satellites so far in 2019 after this CartoSat 3. So India ranks 5th among as such, along with New Zealand, which is a new entry in space sector. So each have 6% of the orbital launch pad. In terms of launches, it is said globally China is set to top the chart of spacefaring nations for the second year in a row. So China has major launches. You can see China's share will be still above Russia. Russia's share is 20, US is 18. So China has so far launched 28 satellites as such. Then on page 9 you have Australia to return 3 idols to India in January. So in January 2020 there will be artifacts returned by Australia, and it is said by the Australian Prime Minister himself that this underscores the world's debt to India's magnificent culture, history and legacy. So here you can see the artifacts, a pair of Dwarpals. And a pair of Dwarpal and a Nagraj. So these will be returned to India. So Dwarpal means door guardians. They are from Tamil Nadu, and one Nagraj, a serpent king from either Rajasthan or Madhya Pradesh. These were purchased from idol smuggler Subhash Kapoor by Australia, and now they will be returned. Because Subhash Kapoor has been arrested, he is alleged kingpin of such illegal sale of artifacts and idols from India. Idols have also been stolen from temples in India, and fake new documents have been created, and entire, you know, transactions have been shown to bring legitimacy to these sales, and they have been sold worldwide. So now these idols are returning to India. And this is Punjab CM son acquitted in multi-crore corruption case. So Punjab Chief Minister Amarinder Singh and 30 other accused in the multi-crore Ludhiana City Centre corruption case have been acquitted by a court in Ludhiana. So there were corruption charges against them, but now it is said there is no evidence and they have been acquitted. Then here you have CIC not asked about RTI amendments. So Central Information Commission was not consulted regarding RTI Act Amendment Act of 2019 or the rules of the Act. So this is what an RTI application shows. So it was in July 2019 when government had not held any public consultations on amendments to RTI Act. And when the questions were raised, Centre said that the Centre had responded in Rajya Sabha that changes in the Act which have been done, there is no need for public consultation. Means RTI actually has been diluted, but no without any public consultation. And it said that at that time that this is between the government and the officers of Central Information Commission and not the public. But now even CIC response shows that even affected commissioners were not consulted. So the tenure of the officers have been reduced, their salary and perks of state and central information commissioners as such has also, the power to determine that has gone to the centre. Even the tenure will be determined by the centre. So their independence has completely been diluted. Even the rules to RTI Amendment Act were notified in October 2019, which reduced the tenure of the commissioners from 5 to 3 years. And their status and allowances have also been downgraded. They had the status of, as such of an election commissioner, but now it has been downgraded. On the editorial page, the first editorial is more bang for the buck. So this is regarding ISRO. So Indian Space Research Organization has launched CartoSat 3 And this article says it has 13 satellites from nano satellites from USA also launched. So it says ISRO should collaborate with private sector to aid high technology manufacturing. So ISRO had ventured into this private sector to be roped in for manufacturing satellites. So that is what this editorial is talking about. And second is caught in the act. So this is regarding the Transgender Persons Act, which has been passed now. So the Rajya Sabha passed the bill. So this has already been passed by the Lok Sabha. So this act has various controversial provisions as such, and the editorial says that this act should have factored in suggestions from the community itself, the transgender community. So the act actually says that the person would be declared as transgender by district officials, so district magistrate as such. So means he has to certify. So such provisions has resulted in it becoming controversial. The NALSA case of the Supreme Court, you can see here, it is mentioned. This is NALSA versus Union of India case of April 2014. In this, the Supreme Court had directed center and state to grant legal recognition to the third gender and ensure that there is no discrimination against them and construct specific social welfare programs for them. Also, it is said LGBTQ community means lesbian, gay, bisexual, transsexual and queer community also had problems with this bill as such. So, calling the transgender persons bill, calling it a transgender persons bill, it said would not be adequate to look into the diversity of these non-binaries. So, it had argued and it called for more broad-based definition. So, narrow understanding of gender identities in this bill has been criticized. Then the lead article is a revival of battles already fought and lost. So this is regarding the Sabrimala case. So Sabrimala shrine, women are not allowed. Women in the menstruating age are not allowed. So Supreme Court had given its ruling overturning this age old tradition and had said that women should have equal entry and should be allowed entry into the temple, including the sanctum sanctorum. So in this case now, at the Sabrimala shrine in Kerala, there have been protests going on and women have not been allowed. Under police protection and undercover, they have been visiting the temple. And now a petition has been filed in the Supreme Court to review that Supreme Court ruling. And on that, Supreme Court said that first we'll have a larger bench set up to look into the question of to what extent Supreme Court can adjudicate on such religious matters. And after that ruling comes, we'll hear the review petition. And in this time frame, Kerala government has said that we will not implement the Supreme Court order. Though Supreme Court clearly stated that we are not putting a stay on the September 2019 order as such. So September 2018 order. So September order of the Supreme Court still is effective and Sabrimala temple entry is there for women, but it has not been implemented. And the battle is again being fought is what this article is saying. A revival of battles already fought and lost. And below you have stubble burning is not the only culprit. So this is regarding Delhi's air pollution problem. This article says that solution to the problem must look at farmers' economic conditions, science and policy change as well. So farmers do not have the capacity to have stubble being removed and spend money on it. Rather, burning the stubble is the easiest way for them. So looking at the economic condition of the farmers, bringing in scientific solutions to this. Because even stubble problem has arisen because of machinery. The machinery which harvests the rice, the paddy, it's such that it leaves the stubble in the ground. So that is why the problem has itself arisen. So looking at science aspect of it, and government should change its policy to ensure stubble burning does not take place. So this is what this article is arguing for. On op-ed page you have Donald Trump, the disruptor. So this talks of President Donald Trump. His performance 11 months before US presidential elections is being discussed here. And you know, various policies of his have been controversial, especially his foreign policies in Afghanistan, in Syria, with Iran, and such. And this is a blow to disclosure norms. So apex court's recent verdict makes several categories of information inaccessible to public under the RTI. So this is regarding November 13 judgment of the Supreme Court on RTI. It reduced the scope of information and widened that of restrictions. So this article says that RTI Act would never be the same after this verdict of November 13, 2019. So it had deviated from its earlier decisions that said that restrictions should be interpreted strictly and information liberally. So the 5-judge bench of the Supreme Court expanded the power, length and scope of exceptions under Section 8 of the RTI Act. It restricted the understanding of terms held by and under the control of public authority. So several classes of information have now been made inaccessible to the public. And below you have gubernatorial restructuring. So you should understand this term also. Gubernatorial means governor related. So the governor as such presently in the case of Maharashtra too, the governor's role has been controversial. Governors are appointed by the center in the states and they are like a representative of the center or as such in the states. So appointment and tenure of governors, this article says, need to undergo radical reform. So they should not be puppets in the hands of the central government and obstructing the functioning and formation of government in states. On page 12, you have terror incidents down to almost nil in Jammu and Kashmir. So this is Defence Minister Rajnath Singh who has stated in the Lok Sabha that normalcy has returned to Jammu and Kashmir very fast and terror incidents are now, substantially come down to almost nil. So recently we heard of terror attack in which a sarpanch was killed and this is the claim being made in the Lok Sabha. Then, regarding Jammu and Kashmir corruption challenge Supreme Court, this has come often quite in news. So when some significant development takes place in this matter, we'll discuss. Then this is government admits to gaps in data harvest. So, Union government has admitted that there was shortcomings in collection of data and it has welcomed suggestions to improve it. So, here you can see it. The government says it's a continuous process, we are trying to upgrade. But taking in only the favorable data and unfavorable data being, modified and so such actions by the government actually raise doubts. But here government is trying to say that yes, there are shortcomings in collection of data and we'll accept recommendations. So this has become an important issue these days. On page 13 you have information security stepped up at Kudankulam nuclear power plant after cyber attack. So a comprehensive safety audit has been conducted on the administrative network of the Kudankulam nuclear power plant following recent cyber attack. And appropriate safety measures, it is said, have been put in place to thwart similar attacks in the future. So, this is what the Minister of State speaks in. This is from PMO. On international page, you have 7 get death penalty for Dhaka cafe attack. So, Bangladesh court has handed death sentence to 7 members of Islamist militant group for their role in attack on cafe in 2016. And here you have Labour says UK government holding secret talks to sell NHS to US. So leaders of Britain's main opposition party, Jeremy Corbyn, he has accused Prime Minister Boris Johnson to secretly be negotiating the basis of a trade deal with US before UK's departure from European Union. And also a contentious plan to extend patents for American drug companies. So here you can see. It is Labour Party's Jeremy Corbyn who has given these details out in the public and it says that there have been 6 rounds of negotiations since 2017 between UK and US. So, the future of National Health Service is specially in focus and it has been said that the drug price issue is there and US companies, drug companies are being given extended patents. So, these big companies from US will be benefited and people would be barred from buying cheaper generic drugs. So, that was going to affect the National Health Service of UK. On business page, you have government extends 15th finance panel term. So, the Union Cabinet has approved extension of the term of 15th Finance Commission, which will now submit 2 reports. The term has been extended till October 30. The first report for financial year 2020-21 will be submitted in coming months before the union budget and second report for the period 2021 to 2026 will be presented by October 30, 2020. So this effectively means 15th Finance Commission recommendations will be applicable for 6 years and not the conventional 5-year period. And then on the last page you have global warming alters rainfall patterns. So scientists say that a shift in key weather systems is stimulating cyclones in the Bay of Bengal. So it is altering rainfall patterns. And you can see cyclones are being witnessed in Bay of Bengal. And there's decreasing winter rain in North India. And lastly here you have new snake species found in Arunachal. So researchers have spotted this reptile inside the thickly forested Tali Valley Sanctuary in Arunachal Pradesh. So the new species of non-venomous burrowing snake. So this is a biodiversity hotspot region. So that is important. So that is it. These are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website asha.com. Thank you.